Gospel of Luke, chapter 14. The cost of being a disciple. Large crowds were traveling with Jesus, and turning to them, he said, "If anyone comes to me and does not hate father and mother, wife and children, brothers and sisters, yes, even their own life, such a person cannot be my disciple. And whoever does not carry their cross and follow me cannot be my disciple. Suppose one of you wants to build a tower. Won't you first sit down and estimate the cost to see if you have enough money to complete it? For if you lay the foundation and are not able to finish it, everyone who sees it will ridicule you, saying, 'This person began to build and wasn't able to finish.' Or suppose a king is about to go to war against another king. Won't he first sit down and consider whether he is able, with 10,000 men, to oppose the one coming against him with 20,000? If he is not able, he will send a delegation while the others is still a long way off and will ask for terms of peace. In the same way, those of you who do not give up everything you have cannot be my disciples." Friends, this is God's word. Will you pray with me? Gracious and loving God, we thank you and we praise you for this day that you have given us. Open our hearts and our minds to the hearing of your word. May we be challenged into action. Amen. Friends, tomorrow is Labor Day. It's a day that I have taken for granted and never really thought about its origin. When I was growing up, I used to watch the Jerry Lewis telethon many years ago. To me, it has been an extra day to celebrate the last days of summer by getting together with family and friends or being involved in community events as I was for the last 7 years. Nichols had an old home day that where they had parade, chicken barbecue, and all sorts of stuff. Things seemed to change after fall schedule begins, and it seems like our lives get into a different rhythm. School starts, different activities take place. What does Labor Day mean to you? Listen to some information that I found on the internet about this holiday. Labor Day, the first Monday in September, is the creation of the labor movement and is dedicated to the social economic achievements of our American workers. It constitutes a yearly national tribute to the contributions workers have made to the strength, prosperity, and well-being of our country. This first Labor Day holiday was celebrated on Tuesday, September 6, 1882, in New York City, in accordance with the plans of the Central Labor Union. The Central Labor Union held its second Labor Day holiday just a year later, on September 5th, 1883. In 1884, the first Monday in September was selected as the holiday as originally proposed, and the Central Labor Union urged similar organizations in other cities to follow the example of New York and celebrate a working man's holiday on that day. The idea spread with the growth of labor organizations, and in 1885, Labor Day was celebrated in many industrial centers in all areas of the country. Through the years, the nation gave increasing emphasis on labor. 1886. From them developed the movement to secure state legislation. The form that observance and celebration of Labor Day should take were outlined in the first proposal of the holiday, a street parade to exhibit to the public the strength and spirit of the trade and labor organizations in the community, followed by a festival for recreation, amusement of the workers and their families. This is interesting, and it makes me think about how much I am taking Labor Day for granted. How are you going to spend Labor Day? What if we were asked to give up this day in order to do something for our faith? Would you do it? Would you be willing to change your plans? How about your lifelong dreams and desires of your life? Is God calling this church in a new direction? Perhaps a new mission project? Perhaps something outside the building, or maybe with another church? If God called you to another direction, would you follow his lead? It's not easy to change, folks, but God calls, and we need to listen in order to be faithful disciples. We all need to step up to the plate, not just one or two people. We need more leaders and workers in this church. We need to work together. Listen to this story that I found. A Christian layman who was also an avid fan of the Cincinnati Reds baseball team once agreed several weeks in advance to give a 10-minute testimony of his faith to a group of new Christians taking a class, a training class, at their church. As it happened, the Reds ended up in a major playoff game that night, and a friend offered him a ticket for free. There was, however, no way he could go to the game and still be present to give his testimony. What's 10 minutes? The man knew he could be excused, of course, but weighed that against the possible help, his testimony could be two persons attending the training sessions. It was not a decision that he took lightly, but he chose to share his faith at the meeting. That was an act of self-denial and cross-carrying, but it also brought him joy to know that he was serving his master. What crosses are you willing to bear in order that others come to know Jesus? How about saying yes to coordinating a church activity and or fundraiser? If you feel that one person or one family is coordinating everything, how about you committing to the task and stepping up to the plate? This passage from Luke, it's a very difficult one. Jesus is being very blunt with the people. It's not a side of Jesus that we often see, but it is necessary. Time was running out for him to get the message across. He was on his way to Jerusalem to literally carry the cross for all of us. Jesus does not call us literally to hate our families and loved ones. What he is saying is that no love in life can compare with the love that we must have for him and to bear for him. This is a hard saying and one that we do not like to hear. We must be willing to give up everything and anything in order to follow him, as difficult as it might be. It may mean taking up a cross, which means taking up a difficult situation or a difficult person or a difficult position in the church in order to be a faithful disciple. As I said before, it may be stepping up to the plate to do your share of the work verses and the next two parables illustrate Jesus' desire that people know up front the demands of discipleship. It will be costly to follow him. Jesus asks, is this a life you can willingly embrace? You may shake your heads, for how can we know? It sounds so hard. Scripture recounts a number of times in which the disciples, citing hardship of the journey, they turn back. They leave the cross. They leave the cost. How often have we made commitments and have been unable to follow them? The lover of the Cincinnati Reds team kept his commitment to share Jesus despite wanting to be at the game. Following Jesus is costly, and he wants us to know that before we choose to follow, for some people it may mean leaving family and friends and going where God leads. That has happened throughout history in the church. For most people, the costliness will come in other ways. It may mean standing up for the truth in family or work situations. Our voluntary cross bearing in commitment to Jesus will bring consequences. In our lives, we remember that we are kingdom people, whether within our family life or work situation or recreation or church life or whatever, wherever we find ourselves. We live under the reign or rule of God. Such living can be costly. It is Labor Day weekend, friends. How are you going to spend it? If you are called to change your plans in order to help another person, would you do it? Would you be willing to carry a cross so that others can grow in their faith? Would you be willing to carry a cross so that maybe somebody would see the love of Jesus in you and come to know him? It is most likely not going to happen inside these four walls. We need to go out and be God's faithful and dedicated disciples. We need to celebrate